Malo ni, halo olketa, and welcome to Tagata Pasifika.
Yorana aloha kakahiaka on the show today. A new play sheds light on the health system in South Auckland.
It's a dire situation that we're in terms of in terms of human beings.
Pasifika children get a chance to develop their creativity using Lego.
The only opportunity these kids get to use Lego mostly is at school.
And we catch up with fashion editor and stylist Dan Ahwa.
You can't be a one-trick pony these days, especially in media. You have to be open to learning about other areas.
Si o te ofatu. But first, the Ministry for Pacific Peoples has been reprimanded for spending nearly $40,000 on a farewell for former CEO Laulu Mekleawanai last year. At the same time, a welcome for the incoming CEO, which cost around $12,000, was also deemed as inappropriate in a review of the spending. Public Service Commissioner Peter Hughes described the expenditures as not being moderate and conservative. Of the amount spent, around $7,500 went towards gifts, with a similar amount for travel and accommodation of some guests. Laulu was commended for acting quickly to repay some expenses and return of gifts, but as the chief executive at the time, he still had overall accountability for spending decisions.
To Hawaii now, where the worst natural disaster in the state's history has claimed 55 lives to date and destroyed the town of Lahaina on the island of Maui. On Wednesday, a wildfire driven by high winds swept through the town and surrounding areas, causing devastation and panic, with reports of residents jumping into the sea to escape the flames. As relief floods into the area, US President Joe Biden has agreed to an aid package to assist residents and businesses.
Our thoughts and prayers are with the people of Hawaii. To health now, and two Pacific researchers have been funded $1.2 million to look into Pacific Islands fertility. Dr. Edmund Fehoko from Otago University and Dr. Zara Marcina Clark from Te Herenga Waka, Victoria University, received the grant from the Health Research Council. Dr. Fehoko says families are getting smaller while infertility is on the rise.
Our people are not having kids, but also our people becoming more career-focused. And we're seeing that with New Zealand Pacific people. They're becoming more career-focused over the years, which also means they're establishing families later. And a contributing factor to infertility is age. And so these are all issues that are piling up over the years.
And the researchers say the three-year project will culminate in a symposium on the study.
And finally, the stars came out to shine at the Pacific Music Awards on Wednesday night. Among the big winners were rapper Mellow Downs and singer Olivia Fuai. Bronson Price, aka Mellow Downs, took out three awards for Best Pacific Male Artist, Best Video for the song Pray For More, and Best Pacific Album for Lone Wolf. Fuai took the award for Best Female Artist, as well as for Best Pacific Language track for her song Sunlight. Other winners include Victor J. Seffel, who took Best Pacific Song for his hit 685, which went viral during last year's Rugby League World Cup. And the late Tony Williams was recognised with the Lifetime Achievement Award. And tune in right here next week for a special on the Music Awards.
Congrats, guys. To our first story now, and a book written by an emergency care specialist at Middlemore Hospital has been turned into a play which opens this weekend.
That's right, it's called Things That Matter, and it's directed by respected actor and director Anabella Polataivau. Niueli Mawafu has this story.
Because Rose is right here, the script says some of my early stories of my father.
It's rehearsal day for the Things That Matter production, polishing up their lines in only their second week of practice.
Being able to connect and fire off different actors and what they give you is always a really nice kind of buzz, I think, as an actor. Keeps you warm and on your toes.
Yeah, have a look at some of the paper.
Directed by Anabella Polataivau, the play follows the book Things That Matter by former Middlemore Hospital intensive care specialist, Dr. David Gallo.
When I was first approached about the play and I had read through it, I read the first pre-prod draft, and that was the first thing that struck me was, it's a dire situation that we're in terms of where we're as in terms of human being. But also Middlemore Hospital is set in South Auckland, and a lot of the times, as we know, it is predominantly you know, Pacific Islanders that are in there being treated for all kinds of illnesses and diseases.
As the play addresses issues within the healthcare system and matters of life and death, it also has a personal connection with the cast.
I was actually born at Minimal Hospital. I gave birth to my daughter at Minimal Hospital. I grew up in South Auckland, so a lot of, you know, just family issues around healthcare. I've had family members in and out of hospital. Family members pass away at Middlemore Hospital, so I'm very familiar with the hospital itself.
Growing up and losing both my parents, especially my father at a young age, fast forward that to when my brother passed away in hospital. And, you know, I think anyone that comes to the show is going to feel something when they watch this play.
And the cast and crew are hoping to draw on these personal experiences as they draw closer to opening night.
Theatre is such an amazing and important medium to tell stories. And the more that people come to watch theatre, the more they theatre can take you away from society and just have a look at ourselves and be like, are we actually doing the things that we're saying that we're doing?
There's a lot of lessons, I think, to be taken away about how we spend our life, how we should be mindful of our own health, but also looking after others around us, you know, medically, but also just your interactions with people.
As for director Anae Arthur Anae, she's hoping the issues raised in the play can ignite change.
Start with what you know, start with that at home and start with family, you know, look after each other.
With David's experiences in Middlemore for 30 years, he really saw the kind of gamut of experiences in that area, dealing with poverty and kind of a lot of the sort of repetitive diseases that come out of the area as a result of colonisation, poverty, social inequities and things like that.
It is about human beings. It is about connection. It is about respect. It is about love, ultimately, and just taking care of one another better. And once again, we can say this all the time, eh, till the cows come home, but does it happen? Who knows? You know, that's the hope, that it does.
Oh, thank you, Anae. I'm a big fan of you and Stacey, so all the best. Get along to all see it best. If you can. Stay with us. When we come back, what will it take to repeal a racist immigration law? We take a look in our talanoa.
Yes, and later we meet fashion editor and stylist Dan Ahwa.
Representation, especially with my heritage and our Pacifica people, really, really matters. It matters in everything that we do.
Yesterday.
Hmm. Wondered when the next crusade was kicking off.
I know for a fact that the Reverend lives with another man.
Didn't know you were off the market, Reverend. So who's the lucky guy? It's
amazing. I'm here for the wedding. Jason's my uncle.
I bet you've never seen someone as pretty as me before.
Real girls are pretty. I don't even know what he is.
You'd be surprised how many straight men like a big one.
Billy! We have to be prepared for controversy. It's
amazing. What did you say to Alec?
It will hurt all of us. Just how
sweet the sound. You'll become an outcast, a martyr.
What? Okay, go here!
Well, that'll solve everything. Drag show in a church, eh?
This isn't just about you and me anymore.
Was it ever?
Standing on the doorstep of my 13th house.
How are you two doing?
Why? Has he said something?
Billy, what happened? That all space for
it. Me had run out. I miss him so much.
He's not into your sisters.
What life did you have before us?
Why take something so beautiful?
How dare you?
And make it ugly.
You're not my savior.
It's amazing.
If you could screw your way to self-love, every gay man would be Gandhi.
When what seemed impossible turns out to be.
Talofalava, welcome back. Well, last week, Green Party MP Teanau Tuiono's private member's bill to repeal a 1982 immigration law which denied Samoans living in New Zealand from becoming citizens. It was drawn from the ballot. And the bill would give people from Western Samoa, Samoa who were born between 1924 and 1949, the right to New Zealand citizenship. Now, here to discuss this further is MP Teanau Tuiono, as well as former Member of Parliament and Samoan community leader, Anae Arthur Anae. Welcome to you both. Thank you for coming on the program.
Oh, kia ora and talofa, great to be here.
Teanau, first of all to you. It's the luck of the draw, really, isn't it, to have the private member bill pulled out from the biscuit tin, and you got lucky last week.
I got lucky last week, and my bill got pulled out of the biscuit tin. I was stoked about it. You know, I'm a first-term MP as well, so it's great to have the bill pulled out as well, and sort of building on the aspiration that we wanted and continue to want from the Dawn Raids apology that we had just over the last 2 years.
Yeah. Anae, this is something you have been pushing for years. 20 years ago this year, actually, you marched to Parliament, 100,000 signatures in a petition. How did it feel for you to see that come before Parliament?
Well, first of all, congratulations, Teanau, for doing it in the first place. And to come out was just mind-boggling, really. And so I'm really thrilled. You know, the time has come for us to now take it to the next level.
It is about timing, isn't it? For this to come forward now, tell us, what's the likelihood of it getting support across Parliament? You've spoken to different parties, Teanau.
Yeah, I've spoken to folks in the Labor Party, also in the National Party, talked with folks in the ACT Party, initially when we put the bill in as well. In order to get it through the House, it will need support from the Labor Party and the National Party. So if you've got connects there, please reach out to them and tell them to support the bill.
Tell us a little bit more about the detail of it. Is it something that Samoa would not like happen, or how many people would be affected by it?
When we first put the bill into the ballot, I went and had a chat with the High Commissioner of Samoa. There's a new High Commissioner of Samoa who will be in Wellington soon, so I'm looking forward to going and having a chat with him as well, to sort of talk about, to see where they are at. We did a little bit of research in terms of how many people would be impacted by this. According to the research that we got, it's less than 5,000 people, probably a lot less than that as well. So it's not a huge number of people, but it is incredibly important, I think, to strike this racist piece of legislation from the statute books.
Anae, you think it could affect a lot more people than that in terms of, you know, helping, especially for Samoa, labour mobility as well?
Well, my concern is, first of all, the Privy Council ruling stands. We know that. It can't be touched. But this is fantastic. Although, from my point of view, there's two things that need to happen. First of all, we need Protect Samoa for a start. And that's the big concern that's been there all the time. The mass migration could have massive influences in Samoa. So I would say that I'm looking for visa issuance on arrival for Samoans, and that gives them a visa to either work or visit, but not to be accepted anything else that we've got going here.
Okay, right? So just to break that down, what you're saying is you don't want to see a turn where all Samoans will be given New Zealand citizenship, the heirs, which what originally was in that law.
Yeah, exactly. I'm saying we can't go to that because the damage that could do is quite serious for Samoa.
Okay.
Right? And this has always been the stand of the former Prime Minister. But to me, the most important thing is that there are Samoans that were born before 1949 who are still in Samoa. They were denied their rights to ever come here. I think New Zealand owes those people their superannuation. And I think that's what we should be striving with this bill that's come through now, to make sure that we make an effort that all those who are denied their rights get what they deserve. And that can be done quite easily and simply. And the other thing, to have an in-depth discussion with the Samoan government exactly how we're going here. Because when I took this up originally, Samoan Prime Minister at the time said to me, this is a New Zealand domestic problem. It is not our problem, right? But in between that, I understood what was going on, and I was never for that because of my concern. I just wanted recognition that this was passed and action should have been taken, but it was taken the wrong way. But today, you've got to look at the world as we are today. If Samoa loses all its talent by coming to New Zealand, we have a serious problem.
Teanau, how likely do you think this will actually happen?
Well, it's as likely as the Labour Party and National Party would like it to be likely. It will get a first reading. It did get pulled out of the biscuit tin. So the way that the process works for the folks at home is you have a first reading, and if it gets enough votes, then it then moves to the Select Committee, gets a second reading, and then on to a third reading with a committee of the whole House in the middle. So the likelihood is around the support from the different political parties.
Teanau, Anae, thank you both for coming on the program. We will be watching this closely as well.
Thank you.
Well, stay with us. After the break, fashion editor Dan Ahwa. But next, how Lego is helping boost creativity in our tamariki.
Kids are smart. Kids are all about being creative. They are inherently able to do this without instructions. Just strong. Keep our culture strong.
Nisa Yandravinaka, welcome back to Tagata Pasifika. To education now, where students from an Auckland primary school earlier this year got a chance to play with Lego as part of the learning experience.
It was called the Brick Pits and it's designed to teach kids cooperation and creativity. Kendall Vano has this story.
For youngsters here at Mountain View Primary School in Mangere, playtime is one of the most important stages in a child's development.
Over here, what you're going to do is you're going to make your own pattern.
Okay? And these small coloured blocks are at the heart of this fun innovation, which aims to educate and foster creativity.
The Brick Pit is about promoting creativity in schools. Lego isn't available to everyone in schools. It's way too expensive. So most schools will not have Lego, especially out in South Auckland. And this is a way that they can have the same tools as some of our more affluent schools in Auckland.
According to Thompson, children possess inherent creativity, problem-solving, and cultural skills that often go unrecognised.
Kids are smart. Kids are all about being creative. They are inherently able to do this without instructions. We're all creative in our own ways, but kids are way much smarter, and we don't give them credit for that. You'll see today that they're problem-solving themselves, and they're working out how to build an insect, how to build a star, how to build a pattern, and there's no right or wrong. It's whatever they think is perfect for them.
And so far, the Brick Pit has been getting the thumbs up from students.
I'm trying to make this.
And what are these?
Because we like this boy's doing.
Have they taught you how to make new things?
Yeah, and I was at home. I didn't learn how to do Legos. Only at school.
What are you making, Lisa?
In Polynesian society, it's all about teamwork, though we don't call it teamwork, we just call it being together. And so if you ask a child, if a child is having a problem and someone's sitting next to them, they can work it out together by saying, have you tried that? Does that work? This is the piece you need. Let me try. And that's what we always do. In Pacifica, that's what exists.
This year, a new addition to the Brick Pit workshops was introduced, incorporating the art of weaving into the lessons.
One of the things I'm most proud of is incorporating a weaving Lego element, and I did a model. I showed some friends, they didn't believe it was Lego. So the whole concept of weaving together comes into that teamwork. It's all about the togetherness of the kids.
The Brick Pit has been running this program over the past 5 years, and many schools continue to run this workshop every year.
The only opportunity these kids get to use Lego, mostly, is at school. And if schools don't have the Lego, they don't have the workshops, then none of our kids get it. There will be some Lego at home, but times are hard. If you can get the Brick Pit to come in and be in schools and let the kids use it, and that's what we need to encourage. If you want our kids to get better, this is the way you do it.
Beautiful. Well done, Mountain View Primary.
Lego.
Dangerous stuff. Do not stand on it.
Oh, yes. Now, to the arts now, and fashion editor, journalist and stylist Dan Ahwa has been plying his trade in the creative industries for over 17 years.
With recognisable works in Viva and Canvas magazines, the multifaceted talent is a force to be reckoned with, as Hanalei Temese-Foliaki found out.
He's the man behind the glam. Meet Dan Ahwa, a true master of his craft, a visionary journalist and stylist who has been shaping the fashion and design landscape for over 17 years.
I studied media studies, film, art history, all the things that our parents advised us not to study. I studied, and it really triggered an interest in that industry.
With a portfolio spanning print, digital, social campaigns, as well as commercials, editorials, and even music videos, Dan is currently the fashion and creative director of Viva and Canvas magazine, published by the New Zealand Herald.
This is where the magic happens. Very glamorous, looks like a dungeon. You can't be a one-trick pony these days, especially in media. You have to be open to learning about other areas. Styling's just a very small part of what I do now, and it's what I started doing. But I enjoy writing. I think being able to shape and craft a story and tell someone else's story As Pasifika people, we are original storytellers. That's always been in our blood. So being able to bring that into the space is really important.
Drawing inspiration from those around him has always been a part of the journey for Dan, especially in a time where brown representation in the creative industry wasn't so common.
When I first started, there was hardly any Pasifika people in the industry. I can probably count on one hand the people that I spoke to and who advised me. We did have this real strong sense of identity and Polynesian pride in the early 90s, and I sort of, as a young kid, was surrounded by that, living in central Auckland, you know, with a Pasifika family.
And remembering the significance of the heritage he represents is something Dan will always carry dear to his heart.
Representation, especially with my heritage and our Pasifika people, really, really matters. It matters in everything that we do. You know, if there's one of us excelling, we're representing everybody else. So I do feel like what I do in this space is because of everyone that's come before me.
With a discerning eye and unwavering dedication, Dan has become a guiding light in the world of fashion journalism and styling, elevating New Zealand's creative spirit to global heights.
My focus really is about making sure that when we're telling a story through the medium of a fashion shoot, it's got to stand the test of time.
A true trailblazer, Dan's legacy will continue to inspire generations to come as he fearlessly forges new paths in the ever-evolving realm of fashion and creativity.
I'm very curious about the art space in Aotearoa. We have so many brilliant Pasifika and Indigenous artists doing great things and exploring their identity. So perhaps, you know, one day I'll sort of segue into that industry because I already sort of bring it into my work with styling.
Well, if you're looking for a model, Dan, Marama's available. Well, that's the end of our show. Remember to get your nominations in for the SunPix Pacific Peoples Awards. Just go to tpplus.co.nz and you can catch all these stories again on TP Plus or TVNZ Plus.
And for our latest news, just go to our social media platforms. Don't forget, next week we've got the Pacific Music Awards right here as well.
Yes, and we're going to take a little break. Yeah, so it's a music special show.
Have a great week, everyone.
O whalahi atu, we'll see you again soon.
Ka kite. Tō whāsoi pua.
Oh, I'm going to jump in. Pacific people love the sun to our new homebound. Tangata Pasifika, born a people proud.